So I have these 6 RC race cars. I also have this really cool RC race track. But the problem is, all my friends are either at work or school, and thus I'm stuck playing with these 6 cars by myself. And even if they wanted to race against me during the day, these controllers don't exactly work at a long distance. And even if they did, they wouldn't exactly see what they're doing.
Did I win?
Now, of course, there's no way that we can hook these cars to the internet somehow, allowing you or anybody in the world to drive them, and then putting all of that together into some sort of a leaderboard so we can see who's the fastest racing driver in the world. Or can we? So starting with the cars, these are actually pretty cool. So they have a light sensor on the bottom that affects your gameplay while you're driving. When it goes over the green on the track, it slows down like you're on grass. When it goes over yellow color, it speeds up like a boost. And when it goes over blue, it starts to steer out of control like you just ran over a puddle. So because of this, we didn't want to rip out the car's factory circuit board and add our own. So we instead hacked the controllers themselves and then manipulated the buttons to our own Wi-Fi board. We had it running and driving just fine individually, but after a lot of issues, we found out that these controllers just don't keep a very good connection with this many cars on. Sometimes you'll click to go forward and it'll end up pushing other cars forward as well. Or the cars will just disconnect on their own, which is not very reliable for us to leave these online all day or all week. So what we did instead was to rip out the factory circuit boards in the cars and replace them with an ESP8266 board called Wemos, which includes a motor shield to control 2 motors, one being our steering and one being our drive motor. With this board, we're able to use the factory light sensor with our own code, and then we made our own connecting board, which uses the connector the car already had. And then we're able to steer the cars with keyboards, phones, or whatever we want, and we don't have any issues with disconnecting. Now, the battery that comes with these cars allows them to drive for about 30 minutes on one charge. It then takes about 60 minutes to do a full recharge. That would mean if we want to have these cars driving for every hour of the day, we would need to somehow swap out the cars that's low on battery, take them off the track, hook it up to charging, replace it with a fully charged car about 3 times per hour so that we never end up in a situation where the cars go dead in the middle of the track. That would mean we'd need 12 cars in the charging area while 6 cars are on the racetrack. Instead, what we decided to do was to upgrade the battery packs on the cars, allowing them to last up to 45 minutes. Then we only charge them every 30 minutes for 30 minutes, allowing us to only use 12 cars total. These cars have a nice empty space above the chassis where we can fit a new battery, and then everything fits together on the outside, just like they did in the original. Now that we have cars that can last a really long time, we need to figure out how to charge them. And we don't want to be doing this manually because then someone needs to sit next to the track all day plugging them in. So what we've decided to do is to create a wireless charging pad like you have with wireless charging phones, where the car can drive to the station and then automatically start charging without needing any wires. So what we did is we created one of these wireless charging boards and we put it right in the middle of the wheels of the car. It looks pretty slick, and I like the idea of magically sending power through the air to the car. The only problem is, since in the beginning, we decided to use these RC controllers as a way to control the cars. As soon as they drive onto the wireless charging stations, though, they're uncontrollable. Reason being that these cars' radio frequency gets jammed when they're on the wireless charging station. Now, you might not say that's a big deal, just let the car charge and then reconnect to it afterwards. But the problem is, each one of these controllers connects to the first car it sees available. So say car B is finished charging first. Controller A might accidentally connect to it first. And then, say car A is finished second, controller C might connect to that, and so on. This can make it incredibly hard to figure out which car is being controlled by which controller. Which is pretty confusing when the next race starts and it says you're the red car, but somehow you're controlling the white car. So we decided to create our own board that uses a spring contact instead for charging. In this case, the car just drives onto the springs and it immediately charges with no interference in the radio signal. That allows all the controllers to stay connected to the same car as they were before it started charging. It's a simple solution without getting too in-depth with the switches or computing inside of the cars. Of course, since we later changed from an RC controller to a Wi-Fi-enabled board, we could use these wireless charging stations since they don't interfere with the Wi-Fi. But since we already made all of our cars with this solution, and they work pretty nicely, I think we're gonna keep them. Now we have cars that are controllable, they can last a really long time with big batteries, and now they have charging stations they can recharge at. Now we wanna figure out, when someone finishes a lap, their time and placement is recorded. And then, when they finish the race, their position is shown as well. And then, when the race is over, the cars will reset themselves to the starting line, and if they have low battery, drive themselves to the charging stations to get recharged. So we don't want to hook up any sensors or cameras to the cars, because then we would need a bigger computer on board. So for the laps, we've decided to create our own image recognition setup that can use a top-down camera on the ceiling to recognize the color of each car. So we assign a tag to each color car with their own name, and then we can recognize when that color car passes a certain checkpoint on the track. This is really helpful so that no one can cheat in the game and just pass the finish line back and forth in order to win. Then, when the cars have finished their last lap, we see who has won, and then we can record that person's standing, log it in our leaderboard online, and then read out the message of being the winner to the winner. Then, for the self-driving of the cars, we tried a few different strategies. After a lot of experimentation, we found the best results from feeding camera frames to a deep neural network that's normally made for first-person cameras on cars. The way that we did this was by distorting the video feed from the ceiling to make the computer think that the car actually has a camera on top of it. And then, we're able to make these cars follow this fake path line in order to get to the starting point or to a charging station. And now for the final piece of the puzzle, we wanted a really great camera that we could show to our players so they could see the cars when they're racing. Now, we wanted something that had low latency first and foremost, but also something that shot in HD quality, which is very important. We went through testing a lot of different camera setups, but to keep things short, we decided on this game to use the GoPro 7 Black paired with an Elgato Generation 1 capture card, which takes the GoPro's HDMI output and converts it to USB so that our computer can accept the video feed and stream it to all the players. We really like the lens that the GoPro has, as well as the default colors and the quality that it outputs. And that is everything. We have the entire game ready, and now it is time to test it. We are in a cafe in downtown Helsinki, far away from the racetrack, so let's go inside and have a race. If you want to play this game yourself, you can go to the link below. It is free to drive. If you like the game, feel free to subscribe. And if you want to get latest updates on our next games, go to our Discord in the link below as well. And if you have any game ideas, feel free to let us know. And maybe we'll fly you out to Finland and you can make the next video with us. Until next time, see you later.